End of Primary Benchmark 2012 English Reading Comprehension Total 30 marks Time 50 minutes Reading Comprehension 1 6 marks Read carefully Fiona, John, Julie and Sam are looking at the school notice board. They read the poster about the National Poetry Competition for Children. All four children like to write poems and would like to take part in the competition. John and Julie are 12 years old, whilst Fiona and Sam are 10 years old. Read the poster before you answer the questions below. Poetry is for kids. National Poetry Competition for Children. Organized by the Malta Poetry Society. Category A. Age 9 to 10 year olds. Topic Summer. Length up to a page long. Category B. Age 11 to 12 year olds. Topic The Village Feast. Length up to a page and a half long. The best poem in each category will win a prize of 50 euro. Applications can be collected from local councils in Malta and Gozo. Closing date. Entries will be accepted up to 10th August 2012. Poems are to be handed in at the local council where the participant lives. Each participant may submit up to 3 poems. The first, second and third best poems in each category will be published in the Children's Poetry magazine. Prizes will be awarded during a poetry evening, which will be held on the 15th September 2012 at the Malta Poetry Society Centre in Valletta. The president of the society will award the prizes. All participants and their parents will be invited to the award-giving ceremony. One. Underline the correct answer. 2 marks. A. Julie has to write a poem which is up to half a page, a page, a page and a half long. B. Sam has to write a poem which is up to half a page, a page, a page and a half long. C. The winning poems will be awarded 20, 35, 50 euro each. D. Applications can be obtained from school, the local council, the Malta Poetry Society Centre. Two. Read the following sentences. Write a T if the sentence is true, an F if it is false, and an N if there is no information given. 3 marks. A. Participants in both categories have to write poems about the same topic. B. Poems are to be handed in at the Malta Poetry Society Centre. C. Participants can write only one poem for the competition. D. Only one poem will win a prize of 50 euro. E. 6 poems in all will be published. F. The Malta Poetry Society has a centre in Gozo too. Three. Continue the following sentences. 1 mark. A. John, Julie, Fiona and Sam will have to write the poems and hand them in by B. Prizes will be awarded by Reading Comprehension 2, 24 marks. Read the following passage, which is divided into 2 sections to help you. Then, answer the questions that follow each section. Section 1. When do the children come? Asked Dr. Maud Biggin. Without looking up and flicking over the pages of one of the many books open before her. The study was full of tables piled with books, photographs and boxes which spread and spilled over onto the floor. Paragraph 1. Dr. Maud was a short-sighted woman who never straightened her back, but moved about at the right height for consulting other books wherever she had laid them. If not reading, her attention was on the ground as if expecting that something very interesting might catch her eye there. She had spent much of her life digging up old cities and graves in deserts and hillsides, and had got into the habit of searching the ground for fragments. She could not bear a vacuum cleaner because it left her nothing to look at. If a chimpanzee were let loose in a shop to choose its own clothes, it would choose much the same as she was wearing. Paragraph 2. "Oh, the dear children," replied her old friend, Miss Sybilla Bunn. "They arrive at tea time. I have made a strawberry cream sponge for them. I hope they have healthy appetites. I am looking forward to seeing them eat." Miss Sybilla's only remaining passion in life was food. Paragraph 3. These two ladies had rented a house in the country beside a broad, slow-flowing river. Maud Biggin had chosen this remote and ancient dwelling because she was writing a book about archaeology. When she had settled in at the house and felt how much room there was to spare, she decided to invite three disadvantaged children to spend the summer there. Paragraph 4. Questions on Section 1. 1. Were the two women sisters or friends? Half mark. 2. Which word in paragraph 1 is the opposite of empty? Half mark. 3. What did Sybilla prepare for tea? 1 mark. 4. Read the following sentences. Put a T if the sentence is true, an F if it is false, and an N if there is no information given in section 1. Half mark each. A. Dr. Maud Biggin spent most of her life digging her garden. B. Dr. Maud was not smartly dressed. C. Dr. Maud and Miss Sybilla had lived together before they rented the house. D. Miss Sybilla hoped the children would be hungry. E. Dr. Maud liked Sibylla's cooking. F. There was a wide river near the house. Five. Underline the best answer to complete the sentences. 1 mark each. A. Miss Sibylla had several, no, two other interests besides food. B. The house Dr. Maud had rented was big and old, big and neglected, old and neglected. Six. Why did Dr. Maud always keep her eyes focused on the ground? 1 mark. Seven. Why would Dr. Maud not bear to have a vacuum cleaner in her house? 1 mark. Eight. Quote part of a sentence which shows you that Dr. Maud was generous. 1 mark. Section 2. Ah, here's the taxi. Here they are, cried Sibylla Bunn. And ready for the tea, I hope. Come in, children, come in. They stood shyly in a row. Ida was 11, but small for her age. Oscar looked obstinate and smart. Lastly, there was slim 8-year-old Joe. I thank you for your very kind invitation, 9-year-old Oscar said softly. Come with me, children, and see your room, said Sibylla. Paragraph 5. As they wound their way upstairs after her, the children were wide-eyed with surprise. They were to share a large room at the top of the house. It had windows on 3 sides, out of which they could see the river as if on a map. It looked smooth, sleepy, and timeless. Paragraph 6. What a lot of islands the river makes, said Ida, calling the others to look out of the side window. We are on one, and I can see at least 3 others. We must go exploring and sail round them all. Perhaps we shall find one where nobody has ever set foot. Look at that island downstream. It looks beautifully wild. Paragraph 7. "Look at this house, reflected in the water," said Oscar. "I can see us all looking out of the window, but our faces wiggle as if we were eating toffee." Paragraph 8. The following morning, after breakfast, the children hurried down to the river. All three were keen to start exploring their surroundings. They climbed into a canoe that lay tugging gently on its mooring. Oscar took hold of the paddles. They drifted happily along, a twist of the pedal now and again by Oscar being enough to keep them on a straight course. Presently the sun came out and beautifully warmed them, and with the sun appeared another host of living things: butterflies, dragonflies, brightly colored beetles and lizards. The canoe drifted to a standstill. Paragraph 9. Adapted from The River of Green Know by Lucy M. Boston. Questions on Section 2. 9. Quote part of a sentence that shows that Oscar was grateful. 1 mark. Ten. Which word found in paragraph 9 means stop? Half mark. 11. Underline the best answer to complete the sentence. Half mark each. A. The house and river scared, excited, bored the children. B. The river was smooth and wild, smooth and slow, slow and warm. C. The children found it hard, easy, impossible to row the canoe. Twelve. Read the following sentences. Put a T if the sentence is true, an F if it is false, and an N if there is no information given in section 2. Half mark each. A. The children each had a room at the top of the house. B. The children enjoyed their tea. 3. Oscar and Ida were brother and sister. 4. There were at least 4 islands on the river. E. Ida hoped to find a deserted island. F. Oscar could see the children's reflection in the river. Thirteen. Write the names of two of the creatures the children saw. Half mark each. Fourteen. Oscar says, "Our faces wiggle as if we were eating toffee." What do you think he means? 2 marks. 15. Questions on the whole passage. 15. Find a phrase made up of two words which shows that there was not enough space for Dr. Maud's belongings in her study. 1 mark. 16. Which word in the list best fits the role the character has in the story? Half mark each. Doctor, cook, archaeologist, explorer, captain, gardener. A. Ida. C. Maud Biggin. B. Oscar. D. Sibylla Bunn. Seventeen. Write one sentence saying what you think happened after the canoe drifted to a standstill. 2 marks. End of reading paper.